Good job, mate. Really well done. That was a fantastic drive.
And with qualifying complete, let's review our top three today. Bennett, Boccalacci, and Valtteri Bottas.
I think we can call that a successful qualifying. We should be in with a good chance in the race.
Great Britain, then, one of only two countries to have held a Grand Prix in every single year of the Formula One World Championship. And the circuit extends that record further for today's Grand Prix. With good opportunities to overtake at the end of the Wellington and Hanger Straits, there's a lot of potential for close action around the 3.6 miles of the Silverstone circuit. With 18 corners and average lap speeds of around 145 miles per hour, it's also one of the longest and quickest circuits on the calendar. With me today, of course, is Anthony Davidson. Let's talk about Bennett. What do you make of their performance so far this season? They've been avoiding mistakes and that sort of thing.
So it's been a good season so far, but whether they can keep that up long term remains to be seen.
Off the back of a fantastic qualifying session, it's time to see how our starting grid looks for today's race. Bennett lines up on pole position, and Dorian Boccalacci completes the front row. Considering the rest of the grid, we have Bottas, Hamilton, Sergio Perez, and Verstappen.
Now that we've got some points on the board, let's continue this form and aim for another top. That's a decent start. Good job. Supersoft. Somewhere on the ICE, be aware that we will start to see a loss of power. Check your MFD for a new strategy option. A new fastest lap of the race. Is showing small signs of wear, power output will be down. Push now, we're boxing this lap. Release. Release. force on this compound. Take it easy on the car. We can't sustain this level of damage. Danger point with the wear on the MGU-H. Overheating the engine will exacerbate the issue, so keep the temps under control. Okay, the gap behind is 3.7 seconds. Stop. That's P1, P1, you're leading the race. laps of fuel remaining. Legs. Let's try to keep mileage on it to a minimum. Of fuel remaining. Increasing the gap to the car behind by a few seconds per lap. Keep this up. This is your final lap of the race. There's only one lap of fuel remaining. Thank you for all your hard work out there. That was a strong drive and a good finish. Well done.
A nearly flawless performance here then, and a commanding victory. And talk to me. What do you think it was that sealed the win for them?
I think that smart tyre management on track and very smooth driving definitely assisted in their victory today. That combination meant they got the absolute maximum out of their tyres at all times.
Well, I'm thoroughly exhausted after the excitement of that race, but I'm sure it's nothing compared to our drivers here. They've worked hard to make it up there, and it's great to see them make their way out onto the podium. So let's review the updated driver standings. Despite the best efforts of our championship leader, that lead has taken a bit of a knock today. So, Anthony Davidson, who would you rank as your driver of the day?
Dorian Boccalacci gets my vote today.